Among the seven continents of the world, Europe is the wealthiest. So in today's video, we are going to show you the top 10 richest persons in Europe. And if you haven't done it yet, please consider to click that like and subscribe button and show us some support. Now let's see how rich people of Europe are. Number 10, Suzanne Hanna Ursula Klatten. Net worth 23.5 billion euros. First person on the list of top 10 richest people in Europe is Suzanne Klatten. She was born in a Bad Homburg on 28th of April 1962. After she got a degree in business finance, she started working in Frankfurt for the advertising agency Young & Rubicam. After 2 years of working for the advertising agency, she started a course in marketing and management, followed by an MBA specializing in advertising. Then she started working in London for a German bank, Dresdner. There she often worked under the name Suzanne Kant. Suzanne came into the world of billionaires in 1982 when her father died and she inherited his 50.1% stake in chemicals and pharmaceutical manufacturer Atlanta and 12.50% stake in BMW. That 12.50% stake in BMW got bigger for 6.52% after her mother's death in 2015. Number 9, Alexei Alexandrovich Mordashov. Net worth 24.7 billion euros. Born on 26th September 1965 into a poor family, Alexei is now first on the rank of Russian billionaires. He graduated with a bachelor's degree from the Leningrad Engineering Economical Institute, later he also gained an MBA. After the graduation in 1988, he joined Cherepovetsky Metallurgical Plant. 4 years after joining the company, he became a finance director and started buying company shares, so he acquired a major stake in the factory. In the coming years, he went on to build a conglomerate, Severstal, acquiring mining companies, coal and steel. He also became a co-owner of Rossiya Bank in 2003, and the rest of his fortune comes from investing in different companies. Number 8, Sir Leonard Valentinovich Blavatnik. Net worth 27.1 billion euros. Lin was born into a Jewish family on 14th of June 1957 in back then Soviet Ukraine. He attended Moscow State University of Railway Engineering, but due to the family's request for emigration visa, he did not finish it. But he did then receive a master's degree in computer science and later an MBA from Harvard Business School. In 1986, Len founded SS Industries, which is an international conglomerate company. Len is still a president and a chairman of the company. The company is making its money from thousands of investments in different industries such as oil, coal, aluminium, media, real estate, entertainment and few more. In 2010, Len donated 87.5 million euros to the University of Oxford and that way he became a founder of the Blavatnik School of Government. Because he is a very charitable man, he donated quite a lot of money to different presidents, one of them is Barack Obama. Number 7, Giovanni Ferrero. Net worth 29.8 billion euros. I'm sure the name Ferrero is well known to a lot of people, and if not, all I can tell you is that they are producing one of my favorite chocolates. Ferrero is a multinational confectionery corporation founded by Giovanni's granddad Pietro Ferrero in 1946. Giovanni was born on 21st of September 1964 in Farigliano, Italy. In 1975, he moved to Brussels where he studied at the European schools. When he finished the school, he moved to the USA and studied marketing. After finishing the college, he moved back to Europe and he became a joint CEO of Ferrero with his brother. In 2011, after his brother's death, he became the sole CEO of Ferrero. And in 2015, after the death of his father, he also became an executive chairman of the company. In 2017, he hired Lapo Civiletti, which took over the company's CEO position, and Giovanni stayed as executive chairman of the company. Number 6, Dieter Schwarz. net worth 31.3 billion euros. There is not much to talk about Dieter. He was born into a pretty wealthy family, as his father Joseph Schwartz was already an owner of Lidl and Schwartz KG. After his father's death in 1977, he became a CEO of the company which operates shops under Lidl and Kaufland. He expanded the business outside of Germany, and now its company, the Schwartz Gruppe, is a leading international trading company with 12,900 stores across 33 countries and is employing over 500,000 people. Number 5. Beate Heister and Karl Albrecht Jr. Net worth 33.3 billion euros. Beate and Karl has inherited the supermarket chain Aldi upon their father's death, Karl Hans Albrecht, in 2014. Now forward together, they drive this chain of discount supermarkets with Beate, her husband and son all sitting on Aldi's advisory board. They are living a very seclusion lives, as there are just few photos of Karl and Beate and is not much known about them, but they are the richest persons in Germany. If you are liking the video so far and would like to support us, please consider clicking that like and subscribe button. Number 4. Francois Pinault. Net worth 35.9 billion euros. Born on 21st of August 1936 in a commune on the north of Brittany in the west of France, Francois had begun his career working for his family's timber business, which he sold following his father's death. Then in 1963, with family's help and bank loans, he started his first business as a wood trading company. The company grew strongly, and because of that, he bought quite few companies who were facing bankruptcy and relaunched them. Then in 1988, he changed the direction of investments to retail companies and changed company's name to Pinault Printemps Redoute. In 1999, he shifted towards the luxury industry, and in the following years he bought Saint Laurent, Balenciaga, Alexander McQueen, Boucheron and 42% of Gucci. In May 2003, he handed management of his companies to his son Francois Henri. And now the company is known as Kering from 2013. Francois is also the owner of the football club Rennes since 1998. Number 3. Francois Bettencourt Meyers. Net worth 62.5 billion euros. The heiress and also the richest woman in the world, Francois, was born on 10th of July 1953 in France. She is the only daughter and heiress of Liliane Bettencourt. She inherited the L'Oréal, which is the largest personal care company in the world, after her mother's death in 2017. Francois and L'Oréal pledged 192 million euros to repair the Notre Dame de Paris after severe fire that broke out in 2019. Number 2. Amancio Ortega Gaona. Net worth 65.2 billion euros. Now richest man of Spain, and in 2015 the richest man in the world when his Inditex stock peaked. Amancio is the fourth and youngest child of Antonio Ortega Rodriguez and Josefa Gaona Hernandez, born on 28th of March 1936. When he was 14, he left school to go work as a railway worker, and then shortly after he found a job as a shop hand for a local shirt maker called Gala, where he learned how to make clothes by hand. 22 years later, in 1972, he opened Confesiones Goa, where he was selling quilted bathrobes. 3 years later, he and his wife Rosalia Mera opened first Zara store. In 1985, Inditex was created as a holding company for Zara and its manufacturing plants. In the following years, it created few companies such as Pull&Bear and Bershka. Company also acquired shares from Massimo Dutti, which was later bought just like Stradivarius. In 2011, he asked Inditex vice president and CEO Pablo Isla to take his place as head of the company. But he wasn't finished, because he started investing his money into real estate and bought Manhattan's Hauwoldt building, Southeast Financial Center and few more. And as an interesting fact, until 1999 there was no photo of Ortega been published, and as of 2012 only 3 interviews were given by him. And number 1, Bernard Jean Etienne Arnault. Net worth 127.1 billion euros. On the first place comes Bernard Arnault. He is also the second richest person in the world. Born in Roubaix, France in 1949, on 5th of March, his professional start began in 1971 when he graduated from the École Polytechnique and then went to Ferret-Savignel, which was later renamed to Nexity, and is a real estate developer company. He was its president from 1978 to 1984. In 1984, he acquired the Financiere Gacce, a luxury goods company, and because he laid off 9,000 workers in just 2 years and sold almost all of the company's assets, he acquired the nickname The Terminator. From 1988 to 1989, he spent 930 million euros to buy the Louis Vuitton's shares, which gave him a control of total of 43.5% of LVMH shares and 33% of its voting rights. In the following years, Bernard was creeping over companies like Gucci and other luxury brand companies by buying their shares. He also bought some wine producing companies and invested his money in a variety of web companies such as LibertySurf, Zbank, Boo.com and also Netflix. He was also the richest person in the world in 2019, 2020 and 2021, and his net worth is still climbing. That was all for today's video of top 10 richest persons in Europe. Hope you enjoyed it and we'll see you in the next one.